right, ladies and gentlemen.
Welcome back to Princes of the Apocalypse, episode 15. We're going to resume. I don't think my printer ever went. We're going to resume where we left off. And I'm going to read something that I was going to print out, but it decided not to print. And I forgot to check on it until just now. Let's see if it prints right now. No, it's not working. All right. So, last time on Princes of the Apocalypse, the heroes had completed their mission for Abbess Helenray of the Sacred Stone Monastery. As promised, they returned to her bearing the hairy head of the werebore Grimjaw. In return, they were granted an audience with Marlos Urnrail, the prophet himself. Down below the monastery they went, inside the prophet's eerie and statued chambers, they saw their old companion, Salik. His wings miraculously had regrown. Foul play, perhaps? However, there was little time to ponder this supernatural healing. Marlos Urnrail dismissed the Arakocra and demanded that the party seek out and steal the mystical spear known as Windvane, seemingly in exchange for Salik's safety. Thence, the Eldris brothers, Fenelon, Sindrin, Pharaoh, and Dirk returned to the Deseran Valley, and with the aid of knights from Summit Hall, infiltrated the hidden temple of elemental air within the lost dwarven city of Tyar Bessel. Escaping detection due to their Feathergale knight disguises, the party was able to penetrate the innermost sanctum of the temple. There, they discovered not only the legendary Windvane, but also the prophetess of air, Pharaoh's long-lost mother. Bum, bum, bum. Once it became clear that her love for the Prince of Air, Yan Si Bin, outweighed her love for Pharaoh, she ordered her acolytes to attack. Chaos ensued, and many were lost in the battle beneath the earth.
That bitch.
The party managed to flee to the nearby Feathergale Spire, with Pharaoh's mother bound, gagged, and unconscious. There, they tricked their pursuers by disguising a corpse as the prophetess and sending her away astride a griffin. Seeing her release, her followers abandoned the assault, giving the heroes just enough time to make a desperate escape to Red Larch, where they'd hoped to recuperate and find refuge. Will the air cultists track the party into Red Larch? Can Pharaoh forgive his mother's abandonment? And what will the Eldris boy's father think? Find out tonight on Princes of the Apocalypse.
Oh my god.
Theme song, plays!
We have a theme song, we have a cold open.
It varies week by week, depending on the mood.
Like, it's like Breaking Bad, where it's just like 2 seconds long, and then it's like, boom.
I am Asimandias, King of Kings. Brian Cranston just reading poetry over New Mexico.
No, we would have like an anime opening, for sure.
Say my name.
And it's like 3 minutes long.
Eldris, you're goddamn right.
Alright, so, you guys at the end of last session decided to make your way to Red Larch, you lost half of the knights that were with you from Summit Hall.
I thought we lost more.
I thought we only got two out.
There are knights left? They didn't all get smushed?
No, I retconned to that at the very end of the last session. It did seem a little unrealistic that they all died.
I don't know. It seems more realistic that the A team walks out alive and no one else does.
So, along your path, after you guys leave and you're sufficiently far from the spire, they think they've lost the cultists. The remaining ranking knight comes up to you guys and says, like, what's your guys' plan? Do you still need us? Should we go back to Summit Hall? Like, it looks like you got what you came for.
They're addressing all of us, right?
Yeah, this is the ranking remaining knight from Summit Hall.
Dirk's gonna say, I don't want to speak for the party, except I do, but we may be able to move more stealthily as smaller groups, so if we split up, that might help. You guys can go back to Summit Hall, we'll do what we're gonna do.
I want to also say, like, things are more, and I, like, look at Pharaoh's mom, and I'm like, complicated than we originally planned, so splitting up is fine if you're not down for figuring all this out.
I've got an idea. I think if we split ways right now, we can do our best. We have a ranger with us. He can do his best to cover your tracks for some period of time. He'll go with you and then double back and cover the tracks. And then we can make our tracks look like a dozen instead of just six.
Ooh.
That's a great idea. Brilliant.
We'll try and draw them off.
By walking on your hands and feet.
Clever.
Thank you, Aridin. That was good. That was good. Good. No bad ideas in a brainstorm.
Can I give him...
Wait, you put these on your hands.
Dirk considers this.
I want to give him something. Like to thank him.
Yes, sir.
Can I give him the bronze claw?
Sure.
From the Umber Hulk.
Yeah.
I'm going to be like, thank you. Here's this priceless thing.
Thank you. Worth about this much.
He's a little confused by it. He's like, I could probably get a good price for this at market.
A token of my
affection. I really appreciate everything you and your men have done for us and the sacrifice they've made. I wish I could do more.
All right.
I'm going to write a wicked ballad about you guys.
Excellent.
Send word to Pumpernickel for me, please.
Who?
Tell her that I'm Pumpernickel.
We're going to go talk to her, Pharaoh. That's where we're going.
Oh, it is? Never mind, just kidding.
They're going to Seven Hall. They're from Seven Hall.
He doesn't know what he's talking about. It's fine.
He's lost a lot of blood.
I've been dealing with a lot lately, okay?
So yeah, definitely. We'll split up.
Cool.
We'll do the cool little fake out.
Yeah, so the ranger goes with you guys and he gets some branches and he's like, all right, if you like drag these behind you in just the right way, and he's like demonstrating the technique and like showing you like I'll do it for the first little bit, but then you guys need to keep doing it after the next mile or so. And he's showing you like try and walk on stones when you can and this and that, and he's explaining like what you guys will need to do as a group. And so I'll need a group survival check.
Oh gosh.
To see how well you guys can do in this. Or rather a group stealth check, one or the other.
Survival. I vote for survival.
My stealth is way better. I have a plus zero or a plus five.
Do you have, wait, Dirk, did you say you have a spell?
No, I don't have a spell. But Dirk is like, literally all of my understanding of survival comes from this one play about a dude trapped on an island. So,
yes.
Like, I'm much better at, like, sneaking.
I'm going to point to every one of us wearing pointy, clanky, clink, clank, clank armor, though.
And all right, like, that's
this, fair. This isn't noisy
big,
stealth,
big,
right? So,
dumb, goofy boots.
Okay. So, the purposes of this, we would say we don't have the disadvantage on
right.
stealth.
If you normally have disadvantage from stealth for your armor, that doesn't apply here.
Okay. Never mind. Our argument there is rescinded.
Look, I've covered my tracks before. One time I was stranded on an island by myself. How did the rest of your story go? It might have happened to me. That might be who it's about.
He paints a face on his shield and names it Sir Wilson.
I was going to say Henry, but yes.
I'm the sneakiest and the survivalist. So whichever.
Thank you for waiting.
Challenge your survivalistism.
All right, let's do a group stealth check then. Disadvantage for armor.
Damn. I told you I was no good at this.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, crap.
Ben, set your drop down.
I fixed it, yeah.
All right, cool.
Oh, I even said it.
All right, we'll see.
You like, lose track of Dirk.
He sees you guys' technique and he says, I'll stay with you guys a little longer. And he stays with you guys for maybe a mile, and then he's like, all right, the rest you got to do on your own. I'm gonna go head back and make double tracks.
Have fun.
Good luck.
Bye. Thanks, man.
Your man dying.
What's his name?
Thomas.
Two N's. No.
Thomas with three H's.
Thomas.
Thomas Matt.
Thomas.
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 There's a lot of phonemes happening.
All right, so you guys, the rest of your trip to Red Larch is uneventful. You guys have some trouble with the track thing, but you know, you're like, this is fine, I got this.
Big sweeps.
Big sweeps. Yeah. Big light sweeps.
Yeah. He said take big steps. My big steps are equal to your normal steps. This is stupid.
Alright.
Cool. Red Lark, woo!
Who's I'm carrying Pharaoh's mom, I think, yeah?
I believe so.
Dragging her, just by her boot.
No!
I can lift her if she doesn't wear it!
We're using her to cover the tracks.
No, I promised I wouldn't hurt her to Pharaoh, so I'm just carrying her.
She's fine!
As we walk, I watch her silently and concentrate really hard and make faces and I'm up to something. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do I notice this?
Sure.
Yeah, it just looks really weird.
What you doing?
Indigestion.
You know, Mother's Day is coming up in a few weeks. Are you panicking because you haven't gotten her anything?
Oh, I do all the time.
I might be a few years late, actually.
This one better be big, then.
Gotta make up for all lost time.
Mm-hmm. An entire baguette.
The love of bread runs in
the family. A dozen baguettes.
A bouquet. Edible arrangements.
Fresh from Waterloo.
Edible arrangements. Is she awake or is she still out?
No, she's awake, but she's bound and gagged and not struggling.
Okay.
She woke up a little while ago.
All right. Dare you good?
I wanna.
Yeah. All right. So, let me think.
Should we just go to Red Larch?
Should we get to Red Larch?
Yeah, she shouldn't be a problem though.
On the way there, Dirk's gonna say, "Where are we gonna put her?" Pharaoh, where are we gonna put your mom?
Not
how
jail.
Big is our house?
It's your house, Jay.
Jake?
How big is your house? It's pretty decent. Well, I mean, you guys have the whole second floor, right? Like, so like you have a pretty big shop, and the whole second floor is your house. So,
I don't know, Theo. What if they come looking for her? I don't want them to like burst into your house and kill your dad, and then
yeah,
maybe
my dad
not
would
kill
not
your
die. My dad would kick their butt.
My dad would wreck them.
Yeah, agree.
But what if like
my dad could
the
be
worst
your dad,
happens
Dirk, shut
and
up.
Your horrible little brother survives, and you have to take care of him?
No, he would totally die. He's such a wuss. Actually, he probably wouldn't die. He'd probably cower like a loser.
Oh my god.
Just saying, we should pick somewhere better. Like, what about, like, the shrine? Nobody's in there.
Dude, usually. But if we go to my house, my mom can make us all stew.
Oh, that's a good point.
Yeah, I think that's important to consider. It's a pretty big factor.
And then Dirk sold.
We could use a nice indoor space, comfy beds, and accommodations. What's your house?
There's beds and, like, you know, stuff. And blankets. Also blankets.
I could use a nice comfy place, cast a ritual or two. I might be able to figure out what that spear is exactly.
We should also figure out if, like... Okay, maybe Lily's not smart enough to, like, say this way, but Lily is trying to say, like, maybe there's something supernatural or magical going on with the mom to make her act all, like, totally brainwashy, but...
yeah, that's what
Leo can't say that, so he's just gonna be like, yeah, maybe after your mom has to, she'll, like, feel better and stop acting so weird.
There was weird shit going on around
the translation there from you know, English to Theo.
A lot lost.
She just needs
he
a
is a simple sword. Creature.
You may be forgetting the idea that she willingly chose this, too.
One time I had the flu, and then my mom gave me soup, and I felt better. Maybe this
See?
Is the same.
Exactly. That's what I'm trying to
say. Hashtag Theo logic.
Native whiz logic is best logic. Come on, guys.
Exactly.
Like, ask for the... Oh, who is the sword? I mean, the spear? Is that Theo or...
I have the spear, I think. Or maybe I gave it to Aridin. One of us has it.
You both think you have it, and then you see Dirk is over on the side playing lightsaber with it.
That's good, that's good.
Watcha!
Matt, see the spear. I might be able to figure out what it is.
Are we still walking, or are we at the house when we're doing this?
Y'all are walking.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dirk, also, that's not a partisan. You can't swing that. That's not how you wield that. Stop. No, you're offending me.
Foxy just yelled a lot and waved it around, and they ran from you. I don't understand these fancy martial weapons. I have a stick.
Dirk's having a great time.
I'm really broken up about my mom, though. You can tell from the way I am.
I know. Bread in a while.
Bread once.
So true.
I was thinking that maybe we could bring her to a priest or something. But maybe the judge in the town. We could use a zone of truth. I don't know how to make one of those, but somebody else might.
Jake, is there like a town healer we would know of?
Yeah, I mean, if you guys remember, that's where Pharaoh's stayed both times. There's a temple. Yeah.
What's I just remembered. There's that one temple I stayed at.
What's the head person's name?
Well, they rotate. So the All Faith Shrine, and every month the people there rotate.
Oh, do you think that her name is Tamira?
Mara.
No, Tamira.
Tamara.
You mean Timora, the goddess?
No. Oh, is that a goddess?
Timora, yeah. Wasn't that the goddess that you... No, that
oh,
was...
Oh, I... Else, no. Okay, you said Timora, and I said Tomira.
No, we're talking about going today.
I didn't say any of those. So.
Kyle!
You're welcome. I'll be here all
night. It's gonna be one of those.
To the church!
To meet someone who maybe is in charge and maybe isn't.
Do they know how to cast a zone of healing?
Well, that's okay. Wait. Sorry. We're still really injured. We still haven't rested. We should rest, then go in the morning.
Oh, I forgot to give myself HP. I have 7 more HP.
See, Dirk's going to propose. I think we should stow her at the church. At the temple.
Or...
So if they show up, jail cells. Murder someone. Well, if they'll murder us.
Well, the temple probably has cells, right?
What god do you believe in?
Well, Savras, but it's the temple of the All Faiths, so there's gotta be some Zonkathun stuff.
Temple
in there,
of right? The go wait the jail cell because you're clearly bad.
It's the temple of doom.
Yeah,
they put you above a lava. Yeah.
I actually
wait. We need to sleep. She's already bound and gagged. She can't get away. We'll all just sleep so we can heal.
Okay.
And then we'll go first thing in the morning.
Okay.
After stew, of course, right?
So,
yeah.
Yes.
I'm going to say this now, just in case I forget later. But if we end up handing Pharaoh's mother off to someone to keep them in their stay or whatever, we have to be very, very explicit for them not to mess with how we have her bound.
Yes.
Because we have her fingers bound for a reason.
Right. Very true.
That would be important. I'll make sure to remember.
Okay, Farrah's not gonna remember. Everybody else remember.
A mental note. And it's gone. It flew away.
And it's... Okay, cool.
Just figured I should reiterate that.
I think that's good. So,
It may surprise you, but I know surprisingly little about the other faiths, actually. I'm excited to go to the temple now. Well, we should probably not tell them that she is evil.
She might not be evil, remember? She might just need...
Exactly, she might not be, so why...
She might just need some stew.
Yeah.
Right.
It may be a good way for them not to go, oh, let me unbind your hands, clearly you are nice, and, you know.
Well, maybe she was cursed, and I'll tell them she was cursed. You don't want the curse to get out.
Alright, so we go to the house, yes?
Kill him.
I think we sleep.
Well, we get there, and then we sleep.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Throw Pharaoh's mother in the basement.
That's why we picked Red Larch, because it was the closest. He said we could get there before and then rest.
And then
that's safer than making camp.
Oh, I think that someone should be awake at all times to observe her, make sure that she's not doing stuff.
Okay, yeah, we can do watches.
I can take first watch. I have to...
Okay.
I think Pharaoh should...
I'll take first watch of Pharaoh watching.
Well, you can feel free to watch with me.
Good idea, buddy system. I like it.
Group, my party. allies.
Actually, buddy system is a good idea in case she gets spell off.
You must know that I am true to you first. This is my mother, and I will not let you harm her, but I would not try to unbind her. I'm not foolish. Do you think me an idiot?
Yes.
Jordan, don't be so mean. Why'd you call him that?
You're always a good guy.
I mean, I wasn't going to say anything, but if you throw it out there.
All right, so buddy system. Aridin, Pharaoh first. I'll go with whoever's second. Who's whoever?
I'll go second. Why not?
Okay, Sindrin and I are second, and Dirk and Fennel take last watch.
Fun one. We got this.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so you're going to have to repeat all that in a minute because I didn't catch any of it. Also, you're not in Red Larch yet, so...
No, I know. We said, okay, Jake, we have a plan. We're going to Red Larch. We're going to our house. We're going to sleep upstairs in one room all together. Pharaoh and Aridin are taking first watch. Theo and Sindrin are taking second watch. And Dirk and Fennel are taking third watch in 3-hour shifts. Three-hour shifts, and we're watching to make sure, like, Pharaoh's mom doesn't get a spell off and that she actually sleeps and stuff.
3-hour shifts means you only get 6 hours of sleep.
Okay, 4-hour shifts, whatever.
Alright.
Cool. Alright.
Red Larch!
Pardon. Alright. You guys arrive in Red Larch in the evening, the sun's coming down, and, you know, people are moving about, you know, they're heading from here to there, from work to home to, you know, to dinner or wherever. And people are abuzz. You hear people whispering and there's rumors going around, and you overhear, and it sounds like, from what you overhear, that someone, one of the members of the Mirabaran delegation, has arrived in Red Larch.
Mirabaran delegation?
Is this delegation? No.
Weren't we supposed to find them way long ago?
Alan!
Did we do that?
Bros are here. One of your bros here.
I'm pointing out we're still really injured and stuff, so...
I'm immediately incredibly apprehensive about all this information.
Agree.
Totes.
What is Mirabar delegation?
The Mirabar delegation.
We catch Sindrin up. We say they're a group that went missing. Theo and I were hired by the mayor of our city to go find them. We explain what happened and blah, 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 blah.
Ah.
In what ways do you think those Mirabarans are delegating?
Good reaction, Sindrin.
Yes.
It's like I lived under a rock or something.
Yeah, pretty much. It's talking town.
Did he ever know about the delegation?
No.
Are we altering course? I would like to not, but I'm open to what other people do.
Wait, didn't he say that he was in Red Larch?
Yes.
Yeah, we're in Red Larch, and we've heard these people being like, blah, 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 Mirabaran person, and like, I think Jake's seeing if we want to change course, and I am down to stick to the plan and then do stuff tomorrow, and we can do different teams for tomorrow. Like, one group can investigate the Mirabaran weird thing, the other group can do with Pharaoh's mom at the temple, like, whatever, but I still think we should sleep.
I'm pretty tired and hungry.
Want some bread.
Alright, so you guys get home and the shop's all closed up and you head upstairs and you come inside and your family's just sitting down to eat dinner and they say, you know, your mom goes, Theo, Aridin, you're back and, oh, and you brought friends and I'll have to put on a little more stew.
Sounds good, Mom. Thanks. Thank Can they spend the night?
My friends.
Yeah,
I guess between your two boys' rooms that you should all fit.
Great. Thanks.
I'm honestly shocked the eldest brothers have separate rooms.
Yeah, me too. We would totally have one room. Can we retcon that?
Like bunk beds or something?
I'll retcon that. Sure, you guys have one room, but she says
you wouldn't have bunk beds.
It'll be a little tight, but that's
fine. Of course, if we have guests, Amos can sleep downstairs. In the shop.
Yes.
And then we can make room for our guests.
I am certain that your guys' rooms is divided perfectly down the middle and is identical mirrored on both sides.
Probably. It's really weird because on my side, all the posters, all the lettering is backwards.
They each have a little rip-off calendar to mark the day, and they each rip it off at the beginning of the morning. Like,
it's a joke. It's absolutely a joke.
Left, the other one to the right.
Cool. So yep. You guys You guys say, like, go ahead and, like, put your stuff down in the rooms, and, oh, who's she?
Yeah,
She's not feeling well.
Oh, well, I'll have some stew ready for her in just a minute. Why don't you set her down in Theo and Aridin's room?
Okay.
Or actually, no, set her down in Amos's room, because you guys, there's more of you.
I'm carrying her, I thought.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
You should set her down in Amos's room. Amos, go go make your room ready for guests.
But ma'am!
Ma'am! Shut up, Amos!
I like shove him, yeah. Got him.
You can talk back when you can make a sword.
He can't even make a cufflink!
That's what Tantor says. That's exactly what Daddy Tantor says.
Oh, Daddy Tantor.
Daddy Tantor is the name?
Tantor is his name, yeah.
It's better than Daddy Warbucks.
And Amos goes, fine! And he marches off and, you know, he cleans up his room and he makes his bed.
Does he, like, run into the door?
The closet under the bed.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, and when he's leaving the room, when he huffed, because he was in a huff, he, like, ran into the door frame.
What a horrible little child.
I really hate Amos. He's the worst. Okay, cool.
So you said... Pharaoh's mom on the bed.
So I'm gonna, like, talk to Fenelon and whoever else is there and be like,
yeah, y'all are in Amos's, all of you are in Amos's room now.
Yeah, I'm like, should we let her eat?
We aren't animals, are we?
No, I mean, like, she's gagged, so she can't cast spells.
Just give her a straw. She can drink the stew through a straw.
Have Mama's boy over here feed her.
I'll do it. I don't mind, but
he's the only reason he still lives.
Can anyone cast silence?
Oh, no.
No.
Oh, no.
Me neither. Why would I do that?
Can I?
Probably not.
Yeah, the fighter knows silence.
Shut up.
He'll cast silence by running over to the mom and just punching her in the mouth.
Shut up.
Yeah, I was gonna say we could.
What, knock her teeth out?
No, like, dislocate her jaw, but...
Let's not. Christ. Save that.
Not.
What?
You know what?
I didn't say it was a good plan, Pharaoh. I said it was a plan.
No.
Just pour soup through the gag.
What does she look like, Grimjaw to you?
You mean Scrimgower? You mean Lockjaw?
Yeah. Mr. Tetanus.
Tetanus, yeah. Well, I guess we should feed her, but that is a good point about the spells. Everybody point crossbows at her?
No.
Just eat! Eat!
Someone holds the gag and someone has a spoon and he's just like, removed, go!
Those of you who are spellcasters would know there are not that many spells that are verbal only.
Yeah, right. Most of them are verbal and somatic.
Especially the kind that you would have to worry about.
Oh, and she has no materials, either.
No, but I'm afraid of stuff like... Fenella knows that Misty Step and stuff like that exists.
Yeah, but again, don't those have somatic components?
I don't...
Or material components. It's gonna have one or the other.
I told you to take the wizard's stuff!
Pharaoh takes the gag off and starts spooning stew in her mouth.
Pharaoh, we don't have stew yet. No, I'm joking. We're fine.
Misty Step is verbal only.
Oh, Misty yes. Step is verbal only.
Exactly.
Go figure.
Give him my
dude, she might not even know Misty Step. Maybe she's a noob.
No, I know, but I also know that spell exists. So.
Oh, Misty Step. Is that water or air, do you think? It's only possible from Aang and Katara's children.
What? Go Tenzin.
I was gonna say, it's not clear.
Alright.
Okay. Well, Pharaoh's feeding her and we'll watch her, and if she, like, starts to talk, we'll just slap her.
Alright. There you go.
And if she drops her food, that's what she gets.
Check out the gag. Hello, mother. It's been a long time. Eat up. Airplane.
Tigger, are you watching this?
Here comes the griffin.
He's feeding her like a baby. How is she dealing with this?
Wait, is she still unconscious? This isn't a
No, she's conscious. She's conscious.
Been conscious for a while.
Yeah. Okay, I just figured it was
very different conversations.
So is Pharaoh going to be in there by himself feeding her? Because the rest of you, like, she's made room at the table for all of you.
I'll sit in there if need be. Like, I don't want to leave Pharaoh and his mom alone.
Sindarin, I'll swap with you in about 20 minutes time or so. That way you can go have your meal.
And eat it too.
So everyone else is out at the table. And like they're being really polite and not asking you about what's going on. They're starting like, oh, you know, business is going good, like
Hashtag small talk.
Sold this many swords, you know, in the last, you know, week or so, and this many, like, they're talking about other things and they're all sort of looking at you guys like,
so what do you boys do?
I'm
like covered in blood.
I'm shoving food into my mouth. I'm like shoveling.
Fenelon is not going to offer any information. They kind of keep looking at her, and she's like, I know enough about smithing, I can bullshit this conversation all night long. Let's I can just keep this about your work. Let's keep it there.
What alloys do you prefer, Fenelon?
Well, really, I'm a big fan of steel. It's very durable, and it's good for everything. It's good for everything.
It's an alloy.
Yeah, no, it's not an alloy, it's a compound, you're right.
Oh my gosh, this conversation got really boring.
Kyle, the materials engineer over there.
Yeah.
Nope, you're right.
Is it still not an alloy?
No, it's a compound.
No.
Why?
I don't know. Like, I'm gonna assume that I'm not picking up on, like, the hints about, like, tell us what's going on.
And so then Tantor says, heard an interesting rumor at the shop today.
Ooh, tell me. I love gossip.
They say the shepherd down the way found one of the members of the Mirabaran delegation. Said he was bleeding out up on a hill.
But that's the group. And I like point at Aaron, and I'm like, but we just and we. Are you sure?
Word, bro. I don't know.
We'll know when I talk to them.
Oh wait, does that get a comment, Jake? Penelon said, "I'll know when we talk to them."
How will you know that?
Mirabar sent me to find them.
Oh, you're from Mirabar!
Yes.
Lovely delegate.
Just like,
what, you just assume it's from Mirabar because he's a dwarf? God.
He asks you about, like, some particular vendor from Mirabar that makes some particular, like, metal that he's bought once or something.
One of his vendors.
The Darkstar Orrery in Mirabar.
He makes the
and she just kind of starts, like, very happy to have the topic, like, derail off a bit, the thing and back to just stuff. She's like, yeah, no, okay, yeah, I'm down. Yeah, the orrery, of course. Just starts just trading info on that.
Yeah, in a way.
Don't ever piss a blacksmith off. They'll get orrery.
And then they'll kill you.
Stumbled over that a couple times. We got there.
Tantor completely forgets what he was just talking about with the Mirabar stuff and is, like, really entranced by all the latest and greatest metals from Mirabar conversation.
We discovered this new thing called iron.
Do you read Forge magazine? Great.
Do I read it? I wrote for it for a year.
Now suddenly Fenelon actually cares about the conversation. No,
this is great. I love our small talk. I'm gonna thank Mom for letting all our friends stay over, and sorry that it's super last minute.
And then at this point, Fenelon's gonna remember, oh shit, Sindarin, and be like, just politely excuse yourself, go grab Sindarin, and send him off so he can eat.
Can we do a meanwhile to see how Pharaoh's mom is reacting to all this?
Yeah, you've got the stew, and you take the gag off, and you go to spoon some stew, and she eats the first couple bites, and then she says, Pharaoh.
Yes, mother.
I'm pausing to see if, like, Sindarin's gonna slap her or something.
You should slap her!
Like, I'm listening for, like, any verbal spell stuff that's coming up, because you can't be like, Pharaoh, spell, ha!
Pharaoh got you with
Look at over there.
Killer. You're not going to let them kill me, are you?
I'm going to try very hard, Mother. Just like I always did, and I look at her in the eyes, when you were family.
You need to drop some Ohana crap. Be like, Ohana means family!
Actually, I am going to I'm going to pull down a tunic and reach in and pull out an amulet, which I think I told you guys it has like a snake, a trident with a snake wrapped around it.
You mean the Deathly Hallows? Yeah, you showed it to me.
Yeah, Deathly Hallows one. Yeah, sure.
I saw it.
I'm going to show it to her and be like, "What is this? Why did you leave it,
ma'am?
Ma'am, ma'am, why did you leave this?
Hey,
I don't want to do dishwasher."
Mommy,
come on. Dick, are you listening?
Yeah, I'm thinking about how to answer.
Okay.
And are you... I look, like, over at Sindarin. Are the whispers because of you?
I can't hear you because you whispered.
Are the whispers because of you?
The whispers?
Damn it, you're on
the TV. Are the whispers because of you?
Yeah. Never mind.
She says, I left you the amulet so you could find me.
Well, it didn't work.
Clearly it did.
But I just had the amulet the entire time. It didn't bring me to you. I don't think.
Of course it did. Oh, did you not did you not see the visions?
Yes, Pharaoh, you did.
Because of you? I put the gag back in.
You only gave him a couple bites of stew.
She doesn't deserve more.
Ooh.
It is really good stew. She doesn't deserve it. Evil people do not deserve this stew.
Also, I am going to cast Channel Divinity Read Thoughts on accident.
Oops.
Whoops.
Are you actually casting it, or was that a...
I'm actually casting it.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, it's not an accident that I clicked it.
So she Pharaoh needs a wisdom saving throw?
Yes.
Pharaoh does not mean to, invade the mind.
What's the DC?
14.
Pharaoh's just innocently thinking to himself, man, I wish I could know what was going on in her head right now. He's not aware that he's capable of doing that.
So you get what's foremost in her mind, reflecting her current emotions.
Like active thoughts, not behind the scenes stuff. Just what she's actively thinking.
She's thinking about the last vision she had before she left and gave you the amulet, and remembering what Yanxi Bin said to her in that vision.
Shit, she was working for him the whole time. Okay. Pharaoh, like, by the way, this is very quick, and then suddenly Pharaoh just, like, staggers backwards and, like, scrambles, and he's like, what?
What?
And then Fennelon opened his door, it's like, Cinder, what?
Oh, yes, read that.
Like.
What?
At this point, it's like, Cinderin, you're good to...
I'm sorry, Fennelon just walks in and sees this, like,
scrambling. Yeah, you're, like, all the way over there, yeah. There's, like, this
mind,
on the floor.
To your mind.
Yeah.
My and thoughts.
She's just like,
to your thoughts.
She just looks at you, Sindarin.
Stands up.
I'm going to go also.
No,
Fennelon, you can handle her, right? Put the gag back in. I'm going to go also.
Bye. All right. Sure.
Pharaoh, did you use your action to end the effect, or is it still going? Because it lasts for a minute.
I use my action end.
Okay.
So, yeah, Fennelon.
I hear Pharaoh coming down after me, that I'm going to return to the room.
No, I'm going to stop you. I'm going to be like, Sindarin! Sindarin!
Yes?
She was always following Yanxi Bin.
What? No.
Pick him up, shake him.
You put me down.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
New friends are almost like they're not friends.
Brandon said put the gag back on her, but he'd also said he'd put the gag back on.
Yeah, it was already on.
Okay, I was double checking that I need to do that or not.
Okay, I forgot about that. My bad.
Okay, yeah. I got really nervous suddenly. I was like, oh god.
Put the second gag back in.
Put the second. Yeah, so.
Pharaoh's going to go off to a different room and just start casting Identify on the staff. I mean, the spear.
I think Dirk has the spear. Well, I guess everyone set their stuff down in the room.
Pharaoh got it from Dirk.
Okay. And while Dirk's bag was probably in the room there, so.
Yeah, so regardless, he's able to grab it.
He's going to look at the spear.
By the way, Pharaoh's mom.
That's awesome.
Oh, shit.
Oh, man, she a looker.
Man, she used to not wear the amulet on her head. It was just normal head, and then her eyes were a little bit less angry looking.
Maybe Dirk can make some really bad decisions.
She's a really nice person.
She was really quite nice.
No,
we cured some
persons.
Helped out people.
I'm so glad I'm Dirk's watch buddy now. Otherwise, it's real horrible.
Dirk is just a big bundle of bad decisions.
You know, I got the name Dirk.
Because I got stabbed.
Like an
right
idiot.
Here.
As a
right
baby.
Here.
You got stabbed in jail. That's a shiv. What?
No.
Did we all finish eating stew?
Pardon?
Did we all finish eating stew?
I mean, Sindrin's just starting, and some of you are halfway. Theo, you finished a while ago, but yeah.
Oh, I'm gonna. I'll wait then.
Anything else over the course
of
dinner?
I'm gonna get seconds.
Pardon?
I'm gonna get thirds.
Oh, of course. Your mom, she's doing a whole second pot of stew, like.
Just for you.
Dude, my mom is the best.
I'm just like, you got all these friends coming, and you're there. I mean, the one pot's for you, and the second pot's for everybody else.
It's very strange to live off of an all-stew diet.
All I was going to say is, when everybody's done, I was going to help clean up and stuff.
Yeah.
What made Amos do that?
No, he had to clean his room, and now he has to hang out with the crazy lady.
Alright, cool. So, you know, dinner wraps up, and everyone cleans up.
I'm not doing first watch, and neither is Aridin.
No, it's Sindarin and Pharaoh.
It was Pharaoh and me.
First watch is Pharaoh and Aridin.
Yeah, it's Pharaoh and Aridin.
I've got them written down here now.
Perfect. Yeah. What do I find out about the staff?
Alright, you cast Identify, so you choose one of these touches, it's a magic item, you learn its properties, how to use them, whether it requires attunement, how many charges. Alright, so basically you get me to read the description of the item. Cool.
Theo, it requires attunement. You need to sit with it for a while, I think.
So, it requires attunement, which, Ben, how does attunement work?
It takes a short rest.
I thought it was a long rest.
Short rest,
wow, that's it? Cool. Nice. Sorry, I had the page up, but then it disappeared. Come back.
Like Pharaoh's mental notes.
Here it is. Oh yeah, I bookmarked it. That's why there's a giant bookmark there. Alright. Wind vein, weapon, spear, legendary, requires attunement. A silver spear wind vein has dark sapphires on its filigreed surface of its polished head. Held by its shining haft, the weapon feels insubstantial, as if clutching a cool, gently flowing breeze. Mm. The spear contains a spark of evil elemental air.
Ooh.
You have a +2 bonus to attack rolls and damage rolls you make with this magic weapon, which has the finesse weapon property. When you hit with it, the target takes an extra 1d6 lightning damage.
Ooh.
You gain the following benefits while you hold Wind Vein. A, you can speak Auron fluently. B, you have resistance to lightning damage. C, you can cast Dominate Monster, save DC 17, on an air elemental. Once you have done so, Wind Vein can't be used in this way again until the next dawn. Mm-hmm. Song of the Four Winds. While inside an air node, you can perform a ritual called Song of the Four Winds, using Wind Vein to create a devastation orb of air.
What?
Once you perform the ritual, Wind Vein can't be used to perform the ritual again until the next dawn.
What does devastation do?
Flaw. Wind Vane makes its wielder mercurial and unreliable. While attuned to the weapon, you gain the following flaw. I break my vows and plans. Duty and honor mean nothing to me.
So that wouldn't do anything.
You emptied the wind. That's awesome.
I'm like holding this and like.
And keep in mind, your mother has you know, carried that spear for quite a long time.
Oh, dude, that's why she cried.
So if you gave it to Dirk, he'd just get a little dumber?
I see it.
I leave the spear in the room, and not, this is not the room of my mother, by the way.
This is Theo and Aridin's room, I assume.
Yeah, and I start, like, going to the party and telling them this, like, quietly, that we have this cursed, nasty, bad weapon that's making thing, and I'm like, and I think it made my mom bad.
How long, okay, wait, can I ask a question?
It's fault. My mom was good.
How long does identify take? Like, how long does that process take?
It takes me a minute. Sorry, it takes me 10 minutes because it's as a ritual. I'm not just casting it.
Ah, okay.
I was just gonna, like... No, that's fine. I was just asking. I was confused. I thought it was, like, a multi-hour process.
No.
I didn't understand how it worked. I don't know how it's spelled.
Yeah, because you can... So, basically, the reason identify is good is you can learn what something does by just attuning to it.
Right.
But if... The problem is... You don't get any warning, so if it's cursed, you're
like the flaw, right?
Yeah, exactly. You just get it. So,
is the flaw lasting, or is the flaw just as however long you hold it?
As long as you're attuned to it. But the problem is, once you attune to it, you really don't care about that flaw anymore because of how that flaw works.
Gotcha.
Right.
Exactly.
And when you part from it, like the flaw takes like 24 hours to go away.
Okay.
How
long is it
stop
attunement? Took it from Pharaoh's mom?
You unattune. You just,
less than 24 hours, Alex.
Can only be attuned to one person?
Yes. Magic. It's basically... the magic sinks to you and you sink to the magic is basically the best way to describe the process.
Okay. Well, I'm going to tell you.
Yeah, as far as I understand it. And you can only be attuned to three items at the same time.
I'm gonna tell everybody, especially Theo, like that weapon. It has evil in it. It will, you'll fly from your bonds or whatever.
Dirk thinks that sounds so cool.
Don't do that. It's bad.
You want to see bad?
Wait, okay. Do you say the word? Do you say the word evil?
Yeah, I said it has a spark of evil.
Okay, I would like to point out that I am neutral good, leaning lawful good. And you, as soon as you're like, yeah, it's for sure evil, and you use the word evil, I'm gonna be like, we should just destroy it.
But I want it.
It has a lot of really useful powers, especially.
That's something an evil person would say.
Do you think we should learn anything about if we could part as smiths?
Yeah, you could find all the springs, you're right. Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
it does have many useful attributes if we are fighting, you know, the air cult who comes after us for my mother.
I hear that.
Much cost.
You know what? This is heavy shit, Doc. We should sleep on it.
Is that word again? Heavy? Is everything heavy in the past?
Is the with gravity in the future? I say we sleep on it and further discuss tomorrow.
I'm just making it because of the game.
Okay. Let's sleep on it.
Jane, I'm assuming people go to bed.
You're on first watch, Pharaoh.
Oh yeah, sorry, my bad. I mean,
Pharaoh and Aridin are first watch. So everyone else is gonna go to bed in so Theo, Sindrin, Dirk, Fennel, and you guys are gonna go to bed in Theo and Aridin's room. So you know, there's two beds and then there's the floor.
Fine, get out my bedroll. Yeah, just get out my bedroll, set it up.
Dirk just flops on the floor.
Cool.
He's just used to it.
Pharaoh and Aridin are gonna watch Pharaoh's mom for the first watch.
Did you want to?
Go ahead.
Okay. I wanted to stay up. Not like secretly, like I'm not gonna like be sly about it, but like I was gonna help clean up after dinner and then like talk to my dad and my mom and like if they asked me like what's going on, I was just gonna like tell them everything.
Sorry, so since you're gonna tell your parents? Okay, cool. Like, yeah, towards the end of the night, they come to Theo and they say, we didn't want to ask with your friends there at dinner, but what the hell is going on?
I tell them, like, all the stuff that's happened and everything we've done, and I told him about Uma Stormbanger and
Stormbanger. Dang, that upgraded.
I like her name
was actually Yancey Bin's boss.
That was Jared's stripper name for a very short period he doesn't like to talk about.
Oh, you mean Great Aunt Uma?
Yeah! See, I told you we were related. He's so nice.
Not quite grandma.
Anyways.
Yeah, it's your mom's aunt.
Yeah. I told them all the stuff's going on and, like, how we're conflicted because of this thing. Like, we didn't know the prophet would be great with mom and, like, all this stuff. And I tell them how Pharaoh said the thing was evil when I totally want to destroy it.
Alright.
You tell them that my girlfriend died?
Yes, I told them your girlfriend died. I'm like, be nice to Aridin because this horrible thing happened to him.
Oh, poor Aridin, you know, your mom.
I had to put her corpse on a hippogriff and make her
cry. I do not mention that. I completely leave that out. I'm like, yeah, we tricked them and got away.
She smelled really bad.
I say we tricked them and got away, really? And we had a ranger help us cover our tracks.
If Pumpernickel is dead, I'm gonna be mad.
She can't die.
Trail, she brings like, dead girlfriends of this camp.
No, she can't die. She brings in all the ratings.
Yeah, you're right. Pumpernickel. We gotta have the face, you know.
Pharaoh and Pumpernickel is everybody's OTP.
Fenelon, just don't try to date anyone, and you'll be fine.
Too many deaths already.
Alright. So they're like, whoa, you should, in that case, you should definitely swing by the temple tomorrow and figure out what the deal is with this Mirabaran delegation person.
Agreed.
And also the prophetess.
You're asleep.
Oh.
No, he's not. He's in the room watching his mom.
You're on watch. You're not here.
He's on mom watch.
Mom watch?
He's on Overwatch.
Alright, now I'm hella tired because I wasted all my breath telling him everything, so I go to sleep.
Cool.
And I'm totally not gonna wake up for my watch.
Pharaoh! Dude, watch buddies.
Yeah!
Check it out. Dude, have you ever noticed that our names lend themselves perfectly to a team name?
What do you mean?
Team Faradin. What up? It's awesome. High five!
What about Team Theoden? My mother is here. She might be killed soon. Not by me, of course, Mother.
You're saying this in front of your mom, yeah?
She thought it was cool. Trying to keep it light, man.
Alex.
She's pretty smart. Much smarter than me. You wouldn't believe how smart she is.
Do the plan. Get him on our side.
Oh, yeah. I thought you were... Okay, yeah. Fred, did you...
You don't need to do that. We know the eldest brothers huddle and say something and then come back.
Right. All right.
Yes. Okay. So the Eldritch Brothers totally orchestrated this.
Yeah.
You got some stew, right, Pharaoh?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm eating it.
Yeah. Oh, you didn't get any bread, did you?
They did not offer me any. Is there bread here?
Amos ate the last piece. My guy.
You fucking what?
Not right.
Oh my god.
Is Amos your brother?
Yes.
Seems like a shitty brother.
He is.
He's a shitty brother.
One sec. Hold on. Give me one moment. And I start casting augury, seeing what, like, if it would be wield or woe if we went and poured honey on Amos's hair in his sleep.
We have an ant problem.
Oh god, okay.
Wheel.
No, augury. It's all wrong, but he does it anyway because it's worth it.
Wheel and woe.
Oh my god.
Sovereign's never told me to play the safe route. Where do you keep your honey? We begin planning. Gotta be in the morning so the ants are out. I know ants, trust me. Ants live in my house. Ants aren't out at night. It's like 5 a.m. up.
Isn't your house the ground?
Not Pharaoh's house, that's my house, my real life house.
Oh.
Yeah, we got
Does anything happen while we're on watch?
Secretly, what I'm asking for the... Oh, no, wait, never mind. We already did it. It's not important. It's not important.
What?
Nothing. I'm also going to do another thing later.
Okay.
Before my watch is over.
Did you just pick up your cat in her bed?
That's what I'd do to move it.
And she didn't run away? Wow.
B-cam, where is it? Where's the plus to seven slots?
Give us B-roll.
I'm trying to...
Hey, baby girl. Hi, kitty girl.
Ah, yes, the beginning of
Look
the
Look at the kitty cat.
It is a well-documented fact that...
All right, sorry, I've been distracted. All right, is that all you guys are going to plan your revenge and you're going to do it in the morning?
Yeah, dude, Team Ferritin strikes.
All right, cool. It's about 4 hours, and you know that Theo and Zindran are next.
I'm going to cast,
So, do we have time to do a long rest in here?
Yeah, you guys
will. Math work out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. I'm going to cast Augury again, which does have a 25% chance for misfiring, now that I've cast it twice.
Got it. Okay. Let me roll
I'm
that.
I'm going to steal...
By misfire, it just means, like, you get a random reading?
Yeah.
Or you choose, rather.
Right, because you don't know. Okay, cool. So I'm going to...
Yeah, 25% chance after the first casting that you get a random one.
Got it. Okay. What are you auguring?
What would be the result of me letting my mother go?
Is this so? The perspective is important here.
It only goes a certain amount of time. Like an action. Oh no, wait. It doesn't have
within
a
the
time.
Immediate. Next 30 minutes?
Nothing.
Well, no, it's an omen from the results of a specific course of action that you take within the next 30 minutes.
Ah. And here's the question, like, you know, wheel and woe, whatever, those are perspective. Is it for you or for everybody or?
Well, it's an otherworldly entity, so I guess it.
And I guess for you, right? Because
it's from my understanding, it's kind of like a general consensus of what his opinion would be on the situation. So since he'd be asking Sovereign how Sovereign would look at it.
Yeah.
Sovereign don't give a shit though. Sovereign just try to see the future and stuff.
Sovereign don't care.
Every time you ask Sovereign for Augury, he's just like, "Wheel and woe, fuck off."
I guess it's
yeah,
for
I'll
me.
Get out of here.
Wheel and woe.
Okay.
Has there been one that hasn't been wheel and woe?
Yes.
Yeah.
Totally.
Yeah,
one, two, wheel, one, two, woe.
Okay.
Most I don't. They're usually wheel or woe, or nothing.
Yes, because it has to be usually wheel or woe.
Right. Like normally, that's I've been answered today. These two have both been wheel and woe, but like.
Wheel and woe.
Wheel and woe.
I'm really glad that we're 100% certain on the Amos thing, only 75% certain on this one.
Mm.
Tactically.
Pharaoh doesn't set his mom free yet.
Yet.
Buddy system's important, guys.
Exactly.
All right, so you said 4 hours went by, though?
Yeah, so it's Theo and Sindrin's watch, so who's gonna wake him up?
I'll go wake him up.
Alright, cool.
Sorry, tap, tap.
Loud car just went by.
Nudge, nudge.
Can I try to not wake up?
Give me a constitution saving throw.
Give me your bed.
and you're shaking him, give me a strength roll, Aridin.
Opposing strength.
Wait, no, I wanna play this differently. Theo, I found some leftover stew.
Can I choose to immediately wake up?
Boom! Right. Yeah, Theo's up.
Will save.
Bam, eyes open.
Wisdom saving throw.
Yeah, yeah.
Roll sense motive.
Yeah, insight check.
But disadvantage because I'm unconscious.
Yeah, Theo snaps open at that.
It's in Amos's room. I gotta take over watch.
Stupid Amos. Alright, I go.
I don't know how long this dude's been under his bed, but
Stop. All right, and you can wake up Sindrin too.
Yeah.
Give him a nudge.
Yeah, no, he wakes up normally. It's not like.
I don't have to bribe you with it.
Cool, Theo and Sindrin.
There's a fireplace in there.
No, my favorite. How'd you know?
All right, go take watch. Good luck coming up with an awesome team name.
Sindrin?
Ferritin.
Sinio?
I mean Ferritin.
Findin?
The.
Jurino?
Sindarin.
Sindris. That's closest we got to a decent one.
It's taken a while.
You guys gonna do anything interesting on your watch?
Probably not.
Yeah, think of names. Sindris?
Sindris is the closest one we got. I'm telling
I
you.
I planted the seed of doubt.
Sindro did.
No, like, you know, like polish and stuff. You know, just like keep busy.
And if consider murdering Pharaoh's mother.
Yeah, just like look menacing, but not actually do anything.
Pharaoh's really mom is sleeping.
Yeah, really important mechanical question. Just that's miscellaneous. Where is the spear?
It's in the room with the sleeping people, not in the room with the mom.
Got it.
Is someone gonna pull a Pippin? Come and grab it.
No.
Dirk wants that thing so bad.
Ah, schnash, keep on. All
right. Sindrin, yeah, Theo, anything? You guys gonna do anything during your watch?
No, I'm gonna like polish my daggers and, you know, like reorganize my stuff and
cool.
Make sure my guild letter is still legit.
Talk about how Pharaoh has some serious mommy issues.
Yeah, that my mom was found and gagged and evil. That's my mom issue. Just one.
Just one.
Well, that sounds like three issues.
Kind of three bound gagged and evil.
All right, cool. At the end of your watch, Dirk and Fennelin are next.
Yeah, you come back. Fennelin's up, like shaking Dirk. Already. Like, get up.
Dirk wakes up and tries to punch Fennel in the face because that's just how he wakes up.
Doesn't dodge, just like takes it on the chin. Is like, blinks. Really?
No. Oh, good morning.
Ow!
We did this last time. We can do this again. We did this last time.
It still hurts.
I one ship it. Dirk and Fennel. All right, you guys are gonna go take your watch.
Yeah.
Gonna do anything interesting?
Dirk wants to go fiddle with the spear. But, like, not like that.
I wonder.
That's really all he's interested in right
so
now.
The spear's in the room that you guys were sleeping in, not in the room with the
right,
watching
so, right, right,
oh,
take
oh,
it.
Then never mind.
You're not gonna, you don't want to take it with us, I'm assuming.
No, I'm not stupid.
Good, okay.
Well, you are, but you're not that stupid.
Yeah.
To be fair, Dirk's actually brighter than the average person. So.
I'm too sleepy to do anything that stupid.
Brighter than the average bear.
I have a question about the wind vane.
Yeah?
Does it, like, have a will?
Good question.
Well, I mean, like, wouldn't Pharaoh
Because I think
that?
It would probably want Dirk to take it.
I drop it and, like, tumbles around the whole room awkwardly and lands in my hand.
It just speaks in parcel tongue at you.
Huh. That's really suspicious.
Yeah.
How long has that been working like that? That's weird.
That's a bad sign.
Hey, guys, do spears usually talk to you guys?
What happened to hearing whispers? I thought it was
keeps telling me to kill you guys, but it feels like a bad idea.
Listen, I need to tell you something. Do you remember that vision I had with the fiery hooded people?
You're asleep.
No, oh, I thought it was next morning.
Third watch.
Dirk and me are taking watch. And
Dirk just keeps talking about the spear.
Yeah. And there's a kind of a pause as Dirk's going on.
It's also quasi-sleepy delirious.
Yeah. So I let Dirk ramble on for like an hour before.
Oh, go ahead.
Oh, no, go in.
About halfway through your watch, Pharaoh's mom wakes up. She rolls over and she looks at you guys.
Okay. This is. We'll go back then because this is actually really important because okay. I was going to not say this unless she's still asleep. Kind of like look up. Kind of. You notice I just keep glancing at her. And I eventually, after like an hour of Dirk just rambling, it's like.
You know, if he had stayed down, I was gonna kill her.
Huh? Yeah.
Yeah, if they hadn't woken him up, she was done. This is too complicated.
I mean, it's not plan A, but it's definitely plan B.
No, her people killed and captured parts of my people. They corrupted one of our cities, and they plan to inflict and destroy my city. Like, if...
Wasn't all that bad.
Yeah. If Pharaoh, hadn't been awake, I would have entered there and then, because it would be far simpler than this.
Well, now's probably a bad time, as someone who knows about murder, which I wouldn't.
There's just a slight eyebrow raise, but no comment.
I mean, just hypothetically speaking, now's not a good time.
No, now it's to messy, and we're going to have another conversation in the future.
So a little bit later, she wakes up, rolls over, looks at you guys, just like cold stare, angry.
Why do you think Dirk was in prison to get stabbed?
Just a very gentle, like, as she kind of like just looks over, very gentle, like, not threatening, but not threatening, like... kind of just gentle shift the weight of the warhammer off of the shoulder and onto like, or war pick rather, and just like kind of lightly patting the flat end of it against the hand, just like more of just like I'm fidgeting with something, but still like, hey, I have a weapon and I'm literally 2 feet from you.
Spoopy,
chill, don't glare at me, I will win this.
She glares at you some more.
Yeah,
Dirk definitely snoops in Amos's stuff.
Feel that you lost.
Oh, let me guess. He has a stupid, like, rock collection or some.
When you open the closet, it all falls out into the room. It's a fucking mess.
And not like rooms, like anvils.
What would the equivalent, the medieval equivalent of, you know, the stolen Playboys under the bed be?
Lusty Argonian maids.
Some etchings.
Etchings. Tapestry.
One of those like, pots.
Look what crazy.
Like, there's totally, like, a pile of etchings in there.
Wow. Amos is weird. I'm saying that.
Oh, I forgot to put honey in his hair.
Dirk does that unbidden.
So much to do, so little time.
He had that idea. He just decides to do that.
So, Dirk, you're going to go downstairs and put some honey in Amos's hair?
Yeah.
All right, cool. It goes.
He didn't hear about them wanting to do it. He just decided to do it.
It goes off without a hitch.
Coincidence.
Yes.
So I'm gonna assume that Pharaoh did it. Pharaoh's gonna assume that I did it.
Yeah, that's what I was just thinking.
Good.
Cool.
Prisoner's
so,
dilemma.
At the end of their watch, all y'all wake up. You know, I've been sleeping for 8 hours. And it's the morning.
Mom. By the way, Dirk, do you come back?
From where?
Downstairs? Yeah.
No, like, does he just, I like the mental image of Dirk goes down. He's like, hold on, I'll be right back. And then accidentally he forgets and, like, goes back to bed. And now he's just sitting there like...
That would be a good time.
It's like, no, we've committed to this. But at the same time, she's like, I really wanted to. That would have been a great plan. That would have been a beautiful... No. No, wouldn't do it now. It's like, we've committed to this. This is what we're doing now. But it's like, this would have been a great... This would be so much easier. Nope, but nope, we're doing this now. It's like...
Oh, yeah, no, Dirk doesn't come back. Windvane catches his eye.
Ooh.
I just think that's really cool.
Are you gonna take it?
Well, like, I can't hide it.
Yeah, but if you grab it, you have enough time for a short rest.
Yeah, I attune to it.
Oh, shit.
All right. Dirk takes Windvane and attunes to it. And just as everybody else starts to wake up, they see him sitting there, like, crisscross applesauce on the floor, holding the spear, like...
Mm. Full of a torque!
Yeah, can I, like, hit him upside the head? I hit him upside the head. I'm gonna roll strength.
Dirk loves to fight.
And I'm going to do it with advantage, because he's not... trying to stop me. Damn. How do I roll that badly? I have plus 5.
Why are you hitting Dirk? Oh my god, why are you holding the spear?
It's so cool! Dirk's also gonna jump up and be like, okay, cool, this is a scrap.
No, hold on. Everybody, listen to me. I think that that spear is what corrupted my mother to Yan Si Bin.
What?
I like how Dirk what?
Got, like, Theo by the lapel.
Yeah, I think
that right, you do.
That might have corrupted her, and I think we should take it to the priest, and it has a spark of elemental air evil in it, and it's...
Oh, that's even cooler!
No, Dirk!
Okay, they're talking, right? Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, I eyebrowed Aridin, and I'm like, we're gonna dogpile on him and tie him up. Okay, cool. We go for it.
You give him that look?
Yeah. We have, like, a special eyebrow base for it, yeah.
They communicate purely by eyebrow.
Yeah, so what do we roll?
Can men do that? I don't think so.
Shut up! You're not a twin, Kyle.
Yeah, I was like, Kyle, you're not a twin.
That's true.
The Eldris brothers learned how to do that so they could say horrible things about Amos in front of their mother.
Ah.
Exactly.
It's the twin Amos language.
It means Amos is a prick.
It does.
In fact, most of the eyebrow movements mean Amos is a prick.
Yeah, exactly.
This one.
It's like different language. Degrees of prick, though. It's
exactly.
Like...
It's like, oh, Elliot, the last piece of bread. Oh, he fucked up the entire order of swords.
What do we roll the dogpile, Dirk?
Strength. You guys roll strength. And Dirk, to not get tackled, you roll strength or acrobatics.
I will assist with the strength. That's the last.
I just put in extra points of strength. Oh!
Yeah. I literally flop on top.
Dirk, you get tackled for show.
Yes.
Okay, and I'm gonna say, Fenelon, get some rope. We have another person to take to the temple.
They must be purged.
Fenelon's in the next room.
Yeah, I'm in a different. I'm in the other room.
Yeah, shout. We're all on the same floor.
And you
it's
hear
a small
the
house.
Very common sound, the very familiar sound of Dirk getting just cold cocked in the face. It's distinctive. Just Aridin, bam, sack of potatoes.
Hold on. I'm not gonna leave her unwatched.
Sindarin, do you have rope?
I should. It's a,
I have
a dungeoneering pack, and I think that rope.
I have rope, but I can't reach it. You have to get my rope.
I have rope.
Someone just trade with me.
I reach over and get your rope.
Alright, cool.
Dirk says that he has rope too.
Collectively, we tie up Dirk. But we don't gag him. We don't like bind his hand, we just tie him up.
I think. What if you cast a spell?
Eventually. Is this really necessary, you guys?
Yeah, no, eventually, Fenelon's gonna be like, just hearing this is like. God. You move, I have grounds to kill you again. And just kind of stands up, walks out of the room, and like walks over and just looks at this.
I immediately tattle. I'm like, Dirk was dumb, he touched the thing!
What?
He's evil now.
No, I'm not.
Okay, to Theo, this is all super simple. I'm like, touch spear, become evil. Very clear.
Yeah, you don't know magic, you're like, no, what, this is bad.
Yeah, I'm just like, no, this is very, like, basic, and I it's not complicated for me, so I'm just like, nope, now you're bad, we have to take you to the temple.
Girl, what did you say the spear did to people again?
It makes them ignore their personal, you know, their bonds and their something else.
Honor.
I already do that.
Friends, though, Dirk. Friends. Would you betray your friends? Ever?
I mean,
now you would.
Do I have to answer that?
I think that's
the question.
Dirk.
I mean, there was this one time.
Dirk.
Look at him. It's already working on him. My mother was holding this for years.
There was this one time in a city with a giant aboleth and eggs full of mind control.
Maybe we should gag him.
Dirk. I have one question. Dirk?
That was a long time ago.
Are you willing to hand over the spear when the time comes?
For what?
We need to trade it. Remember, the whole reason we got it in the first place is someone wanted it.
Oh, come on. We're going to give it to him. We should just kill him with it.
See, this is what makes you seem evil.
Quote, I break my vows and plans.
I was going to say, I'm still on board for the destroy it thing. But either way, before we decide what to do with the Wind Vein, okay, out of character, my parents know, like, about this thing, and they know it's evil, so, like, this morning, like, when we get up, and after we've tied up Dirk, and all this shenanigans has gone down, I'm gonna give it...
You're lucky you didn't get tackled by Tantor.
Yeah, you are lucky. I'm gonna give it to Gad and be like, lock this up somewhere nobody can get it, and don't touch it. Like, I'm holding a cloth when I touch it.
Really?
All right, and you're gonna give that to Tantor?
Yeah, and he, like, knows what it does, and I'm like, it's super evil, don't let anyone touch it, lock it up with, like, the crazy shit.
I'll do my best, son.
Right. Put it in the failures closet.
I say something very rude and Orin without meaning to.
Under anvils.
And I'm gonna say, we're going to the temple. Catch you on the flip side.
Cool. So y'all are heading to the temple.
Yep, with mom.
Going to the temple.
One of you, like, between Theo and Aaron, one of you's got Dirk and one of you's got Pharaoh's mom.
Yeah, I have Pharaoh's mom.
I can walk you guys.
Shut up! Raise my pimp hand.
Yeah. Cool. You guys make it to the temple.
Shut up, Aaron. You hit like my dad.
I don't know if that's dark or just hilarious. And I'm like,
Dirk doesn't really know what that means either. That's
dark.
Cool.
Jumper cables.
Oh.
Pharaoh, I appreciated your helping with the dog piling.
You're welcome.
I felt a lot of emotional support there, and it meant a lot to me, so thank you.
I don't weigh much.
Aaron was like, one goes high, one goes low, and then once we're on the ground, Pharaoh's just like, oh!
He's that last guy to jump on the pile.
Just like, gently breeze across it, like...
He actually misses the pile. Jumps over it, because he's just expecting him to still be up.
Pretty much. A little feather. All right, we get to the temple, and...
I look for that one priest to see if he's there, the one that gave me food. He's the one that spawned my bread addiction, you know, it's his fault.
Yeah, Imdar.
You're a recovering bread addict?
Imdar is definitely there.
Imdar, friend!
Ah,
friend.
My friend Pharaoh, it is good to see you again, but you come at a dark time.
Why is that?
We have...
If it's about the Mirabaran delegation, we're getting on it.
It sounds like you've heard. She's dying. I don't know that we can save her.
Fenelon, do you step forward or say anything or?
Very quiet. Wounds. Very stunned.
And a healing magic.
Punch in the ribs. Like just here's enough as well. Punch as hard as you can in the ribs. And then just. Excuse me. I was sent from Mirabar to find what happened to the delegation. Could I speak to her for a moment, if she's at all conscious?
She's not conscious right now, and I'm afraid if I were to bring her to consciousness, it might be her last.
I can heal.
No.
We have what's her name? Limura is a skilled healer, and she is there, but the damage appears to be far too deep.
Oh, no.
Oh, she's losing the will to live.
No! Bah. Do not even say that.
Bah.
plenty of will to live, but...
bad wounds.
Damage from a weapon of evil.
Okay, so I propose that...
More of one of those.
Me and Pharaoh's mom and... Dirk and Aridin stay, like, here, and then whoever wants to, like, will wait, and then people can go, like, observe her, or, like, talk to the healer, or whatever.
I want to go see her.
I want to, like, bring the evil people in to, like,
sure.
There. Yeah.
Okay.
So who's going to go in?
I'll go in.
Definitely
Sindrin, Fennel, and Pharaoh.
That's fine.
Yep.
Cool. Imdar leads you in, and you see this woman, Limura, is, you know, she's standing over an elven woman, and has got, you know, her hands are glowing, and she's moving them over the elven woman, but she seems perturbed and, like, focusing really hard, and it doesn't seem to be working. Like, she'll close up a wound, and then it'll open right back up.
Yeah,
Is the woman's possessions like an easy view, or is it like tucked away in a footlocker or something?
There's a footlocker at the base of the bed.
Okay. I'm not going to like try and open it, but is this one of those things, if they were available, I'd like see if I could get a look at the markings or something. But okay, yeah.
I mean, so Fennellan, you were briefed on the who the delegation were. And this woman matches the description of Teresiel.
Okay.
It may or may not be here, but it matches the description.
Right. Okay. Kind of look at this. Okay. Yes.
I'm sorry.
Okay. I said the water healing thing, because Jake was doing this. It was like Katara with the water healing. It was
funny because we kept thinking the exact same thing at the same time.
I was like, hashtag twins.
So, I'm just going to turn to the healer and, nothing's ticking.
No, her wounds appear to have been dealt by some great evil. They will not mend.
Some great evil. We don't know what happened.
We don't know. A shepherd found her in the valley and carried her here.
Shepherd.
Will time assist in this, or is this just going to be a repeated endeavor?
I'm trying my best, but I doubt that she'll survive the day.
Jake.
What?
I mean, cast a spell.
Oh, Pharaoh is trying to read this lady's mind?
That parchment over there.
Yeah.
When she mentioned the shepherd is when he did it.
You're trying to tell if she's lying?
No, not that lady. Sorry, the unconscious lady.
Oh, the unconscious lady? Mm-hmm. Does that even work?
It's active thought, so...
Unconscious is not active thought.
Come on, man.
So you get a flurry of, like, it's dreamlike thought, it's nonsensical, it's...
There's a big dragon.
You see images of, stone cultists and air cultists, and, you see an image for a moment of Marlos Urnrail.
That's the Earth dude?
Yeah, that was the Earth Prophet.
Who like had the creepy healed Salik.
But then it's jumping, and you're seeing images of her family and her childhood. It's jumbled.
I stop. That's the first time that's happened. So I'm like,
Just give Pharaoh a weird look. Like, why are you making weird noises? And then look back at the.
sorry, I've been able to pick up on a lot recently. They're important. To us. They're involved with the cultists.
If you don't believe she'll survive regardless, though, Macy Callis, we need her up.
Hashtag roll persuasion or roll intimidate or what?
No, she looks down, she says, if I wake her now, we're ensuring her death.
What do you give her chances of survival if we don't wake her?
It's hard to say.
It's hardcore.
I wouldn't say it's likely, but it you know, the gods have worked lesser miracles or greater miracles or however that phrase would make the most sense.
Greater probably.
Greater.
Yeah.
The crocodile goes towards the bigger number.
I mean, lesser also makes sense, like this is not
a big deal.
Yeah.
Fucking crocodile. I used to draw those.
Not really.
We need what she knows. What? We are staying, and I'm gonna let her know. Like, we're staying with the Elders family, and basically, look, if it's looking like she's definitely not gonna make it in the next, like, within the next like 2 hours. Or if there's no signs that she's stabling out in the next 2 hours, send for us. We need to talk to her. But if there is something like, okay, something is taking, it's going to be really slow, but something is taking, fine. But I'm not going to sign this woman's death if there is a chance to get her back. But if this is just going to be this slow grind and nothing's going to come of it.
I will send word if that happens.
Thank you.
Well, is there anything we can do to try to help her? Can we? Your healer, does she need any supplies?
I'm doing all I can. I have the supplies I need. It's a matter of the God's will.
It's up to the divines. You should know that more than most, Pharaoh.
Usually I'm the one who puts the band-aid on, not Savras.
Come on. Thank you for all you have done so far.
Are band-aids patented in D&D?
Bandage would be the
Huntress.
But yeah.
Well, let's try to sort out my mother, and then maybe we can go check out that pasture. Or what was he, a shepherd?
As we kind of leave the room.
Yeah.
Here,
let's do a quick meanwhile.
Sounds good.
Imdar's, you know, he's come out and he's in the room with you guys. So Theo, Aridin, Dirk.
Pharaoh's mom.
Pharaoh's mom.
So two tied up people and two not tied up people.
I mean, yeah, you guys are carrying them. So, Imdar says, so why do you bring tied captives to the temple?
Because they're mean.
Can you hit him again?
No.
Dirk?
Yeah, he's mounted off.
We were wondering if...
I'm just going to do this.
Pharaoh, you were with us, not with them.
Drop.
Oh, shit. I always forget about the do-to-do's.
I'm going to say, we know that... We hope that they will not always be captives, but we know that they've been affected by something evil, and we thought your healing might be able to help, but when you said that someone was injured by something evil, we didn't want to bring them closer in case it affected them. Theo does not understand healing or magic or anything.
Well, let me examine them. Curse lifting is one of my specialties.
Oh, really?
Oh, lucky us. What a
wait,
crazy
can I, like, roll, like, sense motive to see if he's lying?
Insight.
Whatever.
But yes.
He seems to be telling the truth.
Oh, sweet! Okay, I'm very enthusiastic.
He seems to be exaggerating a bit, perhaps, but...
He's confident, whatever. That's fine. Yeah. Oh my gosh, B was on her back and then jumped and, like, flipped over. It was really cute.
Pixar didn't happen.
Basically. I'm gonna ask, like, having them in the temple, like, won't affect the stuff with the mirror bar in person. I don't understand how it works, so.
Oh, no, these things are not related.
Okay, cool, great. That was all I was worried about. All right, cool, we follow him in.
Cool, he doesn't take you to the same room, he goes to a different room. And, you know, you lay each of them down, and I'm sure Dirk is wriggling.
I would say we let Dirk go first, because his is less bad.
And he says, he closes his eyes and his hands start glowing. He says, ah, yes, he appears to have attuned to a cursed item.
Could have asked.
I just go this again. I just keep hitting him.
Still going to be mad after this is over, you guys.
Keep hitting.
Yes, I could remove the curse, but...
Seems Dirk is dead.
It may be more simple to simply wait the rest of the day. Should be fine by morning.
Ah! Really? That's wonderful news.
You guys are going to leave me tied up till morning?
Hopefully you don't have to go to the bathroom. Okay.
And the woman?
Her curse is probably worse, though.
Yes, the curse is deeper within her. I'm not sure that it can be so easily removed.
Is it a question of finance? I, like, have a money sack.
and he like, opens his eyes for a second and goes, like, you know, he looks at the money sack and he says, no, it's not a matter of finance. It would be a matter of time. I would have to consult the holy books and devise a remedy for some time. If you're willing to leave her with me, I could have it done in a matter of weeks.
I like, put my hand on the guy's shoulder, and I'm, like, I, like, lead him a little bit away, and I'm, like, she's a very dangerous person. I don't want to leave her with anyone. We've had two people watching her at all times, and we spoon feed her.
Well, that matter can be solved by coin. If you leave enough for me to hire a few guards to rotate, you know, three should be fine.
All right, but listen, you can't unbind her fingers when she goes to the bathroom. You have to wipe her butt for her.
Yo, did you do that during your shift last night?
Somebody did. It wasn't me. I'm just saying.
Then let's make it three guards and an attendant.
How much would that be for a couple weeks?
And then Jake makes up a number.
No, monks are really good at math. Monks are really good at math. It's all about book bouncing, yo.
The DMG has hireling numbers. They're in there.
Yeah, that's what I'm looking for.
Damn it, Ben.
He was already looking for them.
Aren't the hirelings in the player's guide?
They might be, but I think it's in DMG for prices.
I'm looking, but I think they're.
I'll get my player's guide right now and look.
I'll get the internet.
Welcome to the very interesting
division hireling costs.
I'll get my
cat. Should I get off the monster manual? Just to be safe. Music.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's in player's guide.
Hirelings pays 159 of the players.
Called it. Yeah, because that's a player thing. Like, the player needs to know how much it costs.
Yeah, so
untrained players.
Yeah, untrained hireling is 2 silver pieces per day, and a skilled or trained hireling is 2 gold pieces per day.
Yeah, so you need four skilled hirelings. So
okay, so 4. So that's 8 per day for a week.
Per day for probably about 3 or 4 weeks.
So we'll say about a month. Be safe. So
8 times 7 is 56.
Yes. This is expensive.
56 gold pieces per week.
All right, well, let me count how 20 I got.
Less than that.
Oh, dude, I have so much money. Totally fine.
Theo's carrying all the party funds.
Anna has some flat, yo.
I quite literally could only buy myself a few days worth of food.
Don't worry, my mom's gonna make a stew, like, every day. It's great.
3 weeks would cost you 168 gold pieces.
I feel like...
Wait, hold on. I can buy half as many diamonds as I need to revive her if they kill her for that. That seems unreasonable. We could just kill her, get rid of the curse that way, and revive her that way.
That's one way to do it, yeah?
But now as long as we revive her within a minute.
Wait. Pharaoh's not in the room. I don't even know if there's an option. Ben, actually, what's the conversion from platinum pieces to gold pieces?
10 plat for 1 gold. Other way.
I have 12 platinum pieces, so that's...
That's 120.
Okay, so we already have that just in platinum.
I feel like we could get that stupid mayor to subsidize this.
I bet we totally couldn't. His secretary is such a butthole, she wouldn't even let us see him.
Yeah, but, like, we got him to, like, double our pay. By just being... like, loud.
That's true.
Let's do that.
That's a good point. Maybe... We split up.
Oh, get in on the ground floor on this sweet investment opportunity. It's not a pyramid, it's a triangle. It's fine.
So much better. Maybe we split up and, like, you and maybe, like, one other person go to the mayor and, like, complain a lot. Dirk is good at complaining. You could maybe take him.
We trust him. Yeah.
And then I, like, negotiate with the priest dude.
Yeah. Aggressive negotiations.
Keep things chill. Like, he says Dirk's not going to be dangerous within a day, so we don't need to worry about that, so that's good. Oh, do you want to, like, do back so we're, like, all together again? Because it was right before they were about to leave.
Yeah, sure.
And so, continuing what I was going to ask before we left, as we were leaving the room.
Yeah.
Sarah?
What is your plan if trying to cure your mother is unreasonable or impossible?
You kill her and revive her. It's easy.
Do it a few times until she agrees.
Pharaoh, you heard Fallon's question, right?
I'm sorry, I did not.
Oh, he said, what's your plan if healing your mom is, like, you said impossible or too difficult?
It's unreasonable or impossible. Unreasonable.
What is my plan? My plan? I don't even have a plan for if it is reasonable or possible. If it's not, then I guess one of you holds me down while you kill her.
Oh, shit! Schrodinger's cat!
Fair.
Some things were just meant to be. I cannot change Solvice's will. I will find Solvice in here.
This is the first time Fenelon has ever looked at you with a measure of respect.
Dang. Rough times. Okay.
Like, fair. But yeah. Now we meet up.
Everybody back.
Yeah.
So, this one's gonna be super cheap to fix. We just gotta wait a little bit. The other one is quite pricey.
Dude, it's totally fine. We're rolling.
Well, could we go to that mayor? He seemed really generous before.
And what if we want to use the money for our own purposes?
Yeah, wait, what
are
you...
Wow, selfish bitch, you just showed up and want to get my goat. I see how it is.
No, hold on. What do you mean quite expensive?
It's not that expensive. It's like not even like a fifth of our money, dude.
A fifth of our money could probably buy a house.
It's not a lot.
Imagine Salik were still here. His share.
We're trying to get Salik back. That's why we need to get Dirk off of the spear so we can give the guy who I really want to kill but can't kill because he has Salik the spear so we can get Salik.
Well, my mother could help. Maybe.
Why don't we just kill him and then just get Salik and help?
Ooh, new idea. Okay. I like this idea of trying to get money from the mayor to do this healing thing. We don't need to worry about Dirk because he's gonna be better soon. I say we send some people to talk to the mayor. And then, obviously, like, some people still only watch Fro's mom. But the other idea I have is, what if we ask our dad to see if he can, like, dismantle the spear in a way that it still looks like the spear, but doesn't actually, like, do anything cool. So it's, like, not evil. Maybe he can make a copy.
He would sense it, though, right? This guy?
Yo, there's magic to these things that I'm certain someone in his position could feel.
It also just weighs a weird amount. It's very light.
It's true.
Maybe yeah, carbon fiber. We'll invent it.
Yeah, carbon fiber, fake spear, no big deal. We only need it to get the audience. He doesn't, like, as soon as he touches it, like, the jig is up. But we can, like, be, like, holding it until we get Salik, you know, and then do the exchange. And then there'll be lots of us, and we can just kill him.
I'm gonna do, like, a cash on delivery for Salik.
Exactly.
I don't think we hold the power in this relationship.
But we do, because we have the spear.
Yes, but he has the thing that's perishable.
Yeah, but he was dead before anyway, so, like, what do we
really... I get it, because he can perish. Dirk is on the floor, tied up.
I get it.
That was a funny...
Leek was dead before anyway. If he dies again, it's no skin off my nose. This is... like, a benefit if he makes it. I say we try a switcheroo.
Rude.
And get rid of the evil things so less people are evil.
Not evil.
Shut up, Dirk.
Shut up, Dirk. You're evil.
Hey, Dirk, I'm willing to compromise. Hear me out?
Maybe.
He's evil, remember that.
Slap.
We let you keep the spear, you fake give it up to the man, during the combat we disarm him and you use it to slay him.
Yes!
No! I don't agree with that! It's evil!
But we get to kill the guy.
Breaks vows and plans.
Hey, you can't ask him that now, he's evil right now!
As long as it benefits him, it should work out fine. I've worked with people who aren't exactly reputable before.
That's a good point.
This way he does keep the spear.
I don't want to keep a spear, it's evil!
But it's also probably worth a lot of money. What if we sold it to a not-nice trader?
No.
It'd probably be worth
it. You know, no!
Theo, there's an old saying, the devil you know is better than the devil you don't.
I don't want to know an evil spear!
I don't like this, but this is a solution, and it gives us the extra boost we may need to deal with the problem.
I want to kill that guy.
Can I point out...
I do want to kill the guy! No, my plan involved killing the guy. To clarify, I want to kill the guy.
By the way, can I just specify, we're not having this whole conversation just right in front of the priest?
Oh, no,
Imdar is, like, in...
Okay, good.
Room.
I just want to be like, we're not talking about murdering something.
What were we gonna murder?
It's not that evil, but it's kind of evil. I'm a priest. Shut up.
Yeah, it's.
Can I just point out that he did send us to go take the spear from my mother, forcibly. They're probably not friends.
No, they're not.
Well, we're already letting one person who's holding the spear help us. Why don't we let her?
No. Dirk's gonna be better in one day.
Because your mother killed my people too, Pharaoh.
Yeah, I'm not gonna trust Pharaoh's mom for a long time.
Yeah.
He's gonna have to do the 12 steps, do like 6 months.
No, he said 1 month. 1 month.
No, from
steps.
For the Aridan seal of approval, this is gonna be a while.
It's anonymous.
Elemental cultus anonymous.
Yeah. To be frank,
either way,
I respect you, and because I respect you, I will let you know, honestly, this would simply be better if she was dead, but I respect you enough to not do this.
On that very tense and uncomfortable note, we go forward at least with the trying to get more money from the mayor to subsidize the cost of making this person less evil.
Why would the mayor be interested in helping us?
It was Aaron's idea.
He's really dumb, he'll give us money.
He is really dumb, can verify.
What's your backup plan if he calls you out on it?
Oh, backup
I'm not
plan.
Going there. Aridan and someone else is going. I'm
backup
watching Pharaoh's mom.
To think of it once. I think we should stick with one plan.
No, I'm saying, like, we can do that, and then we can keep talking about the spear afterward, after we see how that goes.
Fair enough.
So... who's going with Aridan to the mayor?
To expedite that, unless you guys really want to do that scene,
no.
I'm going to have Aridan and whoever else goes roll persuasion checks.
Yay. I was thinking I want Dirk to go.
Yeah, I was going to say, Dirk's really good at complaining.
Like, promise if you get to help us.
Are you going
to
untie Dirk?
Yeah. Here's my buddy who's tied up. Let's have him.
You're going to untie me?
Let's go with I vote we go with the... Dirk gets to use the thing and kill the guy plan, and we'll let Dirk do that if he helps us right now, and also helps us later on kill the dude.
But he's gonna break his vows.
But yeah, but it's in his
I
best
really
interest
to, kill him.
To keep the staff.
No, yeah, it's not the fact that he's made a vow to do it, it's he has his own intrinsic motivation. It's not like, oh, yeah, I'm doing this because, no, he also wants to kill this dude. It's not like, as long as we can make it keep ensure that he has personal motivation, for the most part, we're fine unless someone gives him a better offer.
I don't really follow, but okay.
Cool.
You guys all talk about Dirk's motivations above him.
Yeah.
So, Aridan, you're going to untie Dirk?
Yeah.
And hand him the spear? Oh, actually, you guys don't have the spear with you right now.
No, not yet, but that's the promise.
All right. Dirk?
Woo! Untied.
Cool. Now you guys are going to go to the mayor's office.
Punch Aridan in the
Yeah, Aridan already rolled persuasion.
Hey!
He does that, you get
Are you
used
really
to
gonna
it.
Punch me?
Yeah, but like the way Dirk punches people where you're
No, yeah, it's like... No, that's
Can I
the
catch your fist in the air? Can I roll to do that, Jake?
Let's not do inter-party combat right now. Go ahead and... Dirk,
I'm
go
not,
ahead and roll
it's
persuasion.
Not combat. It's not combat.
Yeah, I know, but let's just move on. Dirk, go ahead and give me your persuasion roll to persuade the mayor.
Mm.
All right. The mayor will give you guys 50 gold pieces for this.
All right, good enough.
You managed to convince him that it's related to the mission and whatever. It'll help the delegation.
Ground floor doubles profits in a year.
So
what was the total bill?
The total bill, so for 3 weeks would be 168. For 4 weeks would be 224.
I think, he said like...
Three to 4 weeks.
He said 3, and then you said a month, but...
He said it'll take a couple of weeks, and I said we should plan for a month to be safe, though.
That's true.
We don't want it to be 3 weeks, and then it'd be longer to him being like, well, I guess we can't have guards anymore.
Yes.
So 224. So
okay, subtract 50?
Let me subtract 50.
So 174.
Yeah,
and then
174.
And then subtract 120?
Right, so that's your guild pieces. So you need 54 more.
Okay, subtract that.
Hold on, loud car going by.
That's zero.
Alright, so you took 54 out?
Okay, yes.
Cool.
Everyone, so you do not panic. We still have, like, We have 424 gold pieces, 30 copper pieces, and 80 silver pieces. And stuff we haven't sold.
Should we bank some of that?
How much bread do you think I could get?
I think we should increase some of the numbers that can be easily increased to gold, since most things are worth gold.
Wait, can I, all of you, I have a spell. I think it works.
You can tell
bring
us.
Somebody back.
I have a spell too.
Brandon, you're talking really soft.
It can bring sorry, my mic is badly positioned as well. It can bring somebody back to life.
That's cool. Who's dead?
300 gold pieces of diamond.
Wait, you need a diamond?
I need a diamond. A big one. 300 gold pieces.
Yeah, that's less than 224. Less than whatever we get.
I'm not saying we do that instead. I'm saying we do both. Do we not have enough money?
We do, but why would we bring someone back to life?
No,
I'm just saying I need the
no,
diamond.
He has
if
a
ever
point.
Use
if
it.
He needs to save us,
then he can have them on hand.
Can you use that again and again, or?
No, it's gone.
It's very.
So it's just the one. Oh,
it's expended. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think we should have it.
Ben knows this. Fenella didn't. So.
We can vote on it.
I have to throw the diamond inside of you, and then it's inside of you forever. You can get it back out, but that will reverse the process.
All in favor of diamond life.
I mean, I know a character that would be very happy to know that that was a spell, but...
It's a new spell in Pharaoh's defense. He's obviously...
Oh, I know.
All right, so, sorry, guys. Like, actually raise your hands so I can see on camera.
Oh, yeah.
Cool, everybody voted yes.
All right,
yes, I buy a diamond.
I will subtract...
300.
So we are now at 124.
Cool. And is Pharaoh,
big ass diamond.
You get a big ass diamond, right? Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, this really fine.
Oh, it's an ass diamond? That's how you put it in someone?
Yeah. That's why you can't get it out easily.
You gotta keister it.
You guys are terrible people.
Disembowelment usually leads to death.
Cool. Defeats the so, Imdar says, you know, he says, thank you, I'll go and hire some guards right now. Like, you guys wait here, watch, you know, your guest. I'll go get the guards and the attendant right now, and then you guys can go on your way.
And actually, when he gets the guard and the attendant, if he brings them there, I'm gonna give them the kind of like the rundown of like, okay, you can't mess with these bondings.
Totally.
If they ever look loose, you tie them. Like,
these are skilled guards. These are not just random dudes with swords. Like, he's paid good money.
We paid the two gold.
I like the demo.
We shelled out for this for a reason.
Yeah, they 100% understand. They've dealt with, you know, bound magic users before. Like,
yeah,
they're 100% with it. And they immediately, two of them go in while one, like, they're ready to, they have a whole rotation and they're used to this kind of thing.
Cool. Sounds good. He was doing the gesturing.
You'll find in your weekly issue of Dungeon Mall, you will.
Alright, so.
My weekly message.
Great, okay, good. We handed off Pharaoh's mom. That's checked off. That's squared away.
Glad we took care of that.
At this point, right when you guys are getting ready to leave, Limura, the healer lady, comes out and says, oh, you're still here. Fenellan, you're going to want to come. This is she's not going to make it. I'm going to wake her.
Yeah. No.
I mean, we can all go, right?
Yeah. I just kind of nod. If they want to follow, they can follow, but yeah. So I'll just head into the room.
Everybody else gonna go in the room too?
Yeah. No, I'm gonna stay with the bounty.
I'll stay back.
All right, Aaron and Sildrum staying back.
Wait. You're gonna stay with who?
Mother.
He's staying with the guards. With.
Oh. Okay.
So
I'm gonna go with.
All right, cool. So Aaron and Sildrum are staying back. Theo, Pharaoh, Dirk, Fenellan, going in.
Yeah. And
running.
Just kind of look for a moment, and then just when I get it, just give a nod to the healer woman.
And she takes, you know, what looks like some smelling salts and puts them under the elven woman's nose, and she
comes through.
She makes it. She's in a lot of pain.
Yeah, and there's just I just give her a moment, and then very quietly just, Mihai, and I make the gesture of, it's kind of like the, hey, this is a, it's okay to speak. Yeah, not so much the salute, but the more of like the, like, hey, I know we're supposed to not talk about mission stuff, but like, this is, you're done, we need to talk about, like,
I don't know if there's a salute for that, but.
No, not the salute, it's kind of like, remember how we were talking earlier, it's like Mirabar does a lot, we have a lot of code, we have a lot of, so it's kind of like the signal, like, it's FUBAR, just give me what you got, like.
And she says, the junk, the message.
Drunken message. They gave me what I needed, but not everything. I need you to be as specific as you can.
There's a trunk at the foot of the bed.
Okay, that nods. Like, there's more than one. It could mean like a trunk they were carrying. I don't know, man. Yeah.
Yeah. No, I feel it.
Do you go to the trunk?
Yeah, I nod. Just saying.
Yeah. So there's some assorted things, and there are various travel things, and then you see there is a tube with a scroll, that has a coded message on it. You also have a coded message that was given with you, and you were told, you don't even have the code to decrypt it. You can't decrypt this one you have, and this was like, when you find the delegation, they'll know what to do.
Right.
And she, you know, she takes it and she says, there were three, any two can be decrypted. They must get to Waterdeep.
Waterdeep. Got it. Okay.
They have to be warned.
Warned. Cultists? Other?
The message. It's all in the message.
There's a nod. From the two that are there, am I able to quickly kind of piece what, see if there's any kind of way to decrypt a code from the two scraps?
Looking at hers and yours, it becomes clear just from the first bit that, like, yes, with some time and some work, with these two, the message could be decrypted, but it appears to be missing one more piece. But knowing how coded messages usually work, you can presume that one piece would be held by someone in Waterdeep, if that's where this message was supposed to go.
Okay.
But, like, with yours and that one, it's very clear that, like, these are two pieces, like, that this would work.
Yeah. And then I'm just gonna kind of stand up and give a nod to the healer woman, like, hey, if she's still got anything left, you can put her under so she can go out in her sleep at least now.
You were trying to convey a lot of message through nodding, but yeah.
Not a nod, but it's kind of like, it's context appropriate.
Sure.
Fenelon's a woman of very few words.
Fenelon's eyebrows are massive, and they have very fine muscle control between different sections. Of
Stoicism plus eyebrows.
Tell me with your eyes.
But yeah, just,
Amos is a prick.
She can rest.
Yeah. And she takes, she pulls out a potion and uncorks it, and the woman is still in a lot of pain and making a lot of noise, and she picks her up and tilts back the potion, and she quiets, and then, you know, her body shakes a little, and she's still.
I, like, elbow Fenelon and, like, show him the diamonds in my hand where the priest can't see him.
Mm-hmm. Did she, like, fall asleep, or did she die?
No, she's...
She's gone.
She's asleep. She went to vacation.
Like,
it's
good when you're sick.
Before diamonds. I make this commission decision, do I know? Could I make like an Arcana check to see if I know if in just situations where if healing magic wouldn't work, resurrection
you
magic
seven
would?
7 seconds.
Just have an idea.
You can. Five. You can make an arcane check. Yeah.
Yeah. Just have that idea. Just.
I'm like, I start casting the spell and...
Like, getting it ready.
You don't know for sure, but your intuition would be that if she could not be magically healed, she might not be able to be magically resurrected.
Yeah, and I'm just going to say, Pharaoh, I appreciate your thought, but I don't believe it'll work.
Good, it's been a minute and 2 seconds.
I wish I could laugh at that.
Oh, man.
Let's go.
I feel really bad that she died.
What I'm going to do, actually, is reach into the footlocker once more, and I'm going to get her service medallion.
Yeah.
Quietly take that and just tuck it into my pack.
Can I, like, peek into the trunk when he's, like, looking in?
It's just some it's normal travel gear, a weapon, you know.
Anything cool?
Any cloaks?
No cool cloaks. Also, they're all for a tall, skinny elf woman.
Not only are they not there, they're the wrong size.
Yeah. I'm going to glance at Theoden, I'm going to glance at the healer and basically say, I would be the one to claim her effects for Mirabar effectively, but we have no need of them. If anyone needs anything, you can give it to them.
We can reappropriate her goods for the poor.
Good.
I don't know, lots of poor people that need weapons.
They can sell the weapons and buy food. It's
yeah.
Goodwill.
No, her brother would like that. I'll tell him when I return.
I did not know that, like, Fennelin personally knew her, so I'm gonna, like, make a face and be like, you knew her brother?
Would you, she asks if you'd like her to be buried here at the temple.
It'll serve its purpose.
Okay. She'll be buried by the end of the day.
Thank you.
Do you, like, not respond when I ask that you knew her brother?
I never met her. I knew her brother. I knew her by name. I heard of her, but I'd never met her myself.
Anne, I'm sorry.
It is what it is. Come on.
Man, this is heavy stuff.
Dirk is going to shoulder Dirk and be like, let's go kill that Gorgon asshole.
Let's go kill a Gorgon asshole.
It'll be fun.
Gorgons. I know what'll cheer you guys up.
All right, so you guys are going to start making your way to the Sacred Stone Monastery.
Yep. I want to ask Pharaoh's mom a question.
Oh, yeah, go for it. Well, meanwhile, because you were in there, yeah.
Yeah. So I'm going to walk up to her and kind of loosen her gag and say,
she missed these steps away! You lost her! No, I'm just kidding.
Should never have let her have a long rest.
Damn it, Kyle! No, okay. Go ahead.
Were you aware that we were sent by the Earth Cult to kill you?
What?
You weren't. Oh. That's interesting. Okay. Why would the other cults want you dead?
Plural?
I just assume.
And she says,
I don't know, I go where they tell me.
So Kyle, do you still, on your person, do you have any, like, anything, like, is your cloak or something from the, because I know you
The mask is,
okay, is that, like, hanging on your pack?
Yeah.
On the outside? And she sees that, and she says, well, you would know, the cults have always been at war. We join when we must for the greater... Is it greater good or bad. Greater evil?
The greater bad.
Yeah, the greater evil.
People truly believe
the greater purpose.
For the greater purpose, yeah. Okay. But there's always been, you know, strife between the clans.
Infighting.
Infighting. Prophets have died.
Okay, that's interesting.
You would know. Vanifer's always meddling and trying to position herself.
Who's Vanifer?
No one else is there.
Who's Vanifer indeed?
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm not there. Honey.
We heard the name before.
Yeah, we did.
Oh, we did. You're right. With that, I just say, so it hasn't come to the point where you need to come together. You're still infighting.
What? There's no reason to come together now. They're with everything so nearly in our grasp, and then she sort of realizes. And...
Well, not in yours anymore. And I, like, tie her back up.
Yeah, yes. You're back up. Angry, angry, angry eyes.
Seal approved.
Yeah, do little, like, finger wiggle. Bye. And I walk out the door.
Let's go bowling. No.
I wanted to think of this, too, before we left the guy. Can I ask, what's the guy's name?
Imdar?
Imdar. Can I ask him if he knows where the shepherd came from or went to or found her or any of those details?
He doesn't know exactly the details, but the shepherd was, you know, out with his flock in the east, in the hills.
This isn't somebody I would know?
Oh, yeah, it's Shepherd Jim.
It's Dave, that one guy who's weird with sheep.
Oh, Jim.
I feel like, I'm going to ask Melon, but, like, we should go, like, talk to him because maybe he knows about more about, like, how she was injured or why she separated from the rest of the group.
From what you hear from Imdar, basically, like, he was going around with the flock and then, like, he saw her and was like, oh shit, and then, like, rushed his flock and
oh, was she unconscious when he found her?
Yeah.
She was,
okay. Sorry.
Badly wounded is what they had said. Was
really, I thought they had, like, talked, my bad.
No. Yeah. They found her badly wounded and rushed her back.
Okay. That makes more sense.
Yeah.
Sorry. Cool. Alright, then yeah, we go to Sacred Stone.
Anything else you guys want to do in town before you head out?
Does anybody need any supply?
I sneak over to the bar and buy like a keg of beer.
Cool. I've got snacks.
I assume you go back to pick up the spear for Dirk, because...
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Dirk would not leave without it.
Cool.
No. And unlike Dirk, Fenelon honors her deal, so...
Cool.
But Dirk didn't do that before, so...
Yeah.
And then you guys head off for Sacred Stone Monastery. We're going to leave it right there because it's 10 o'clock. And we will continue next time at the Sacred Stone Monastery. Everybody, I'd like you, remember, please message me tonight, not tomorrow or later when I bother you tonight, with your rose thorn bud, right? Something you liked, something you didn't like, something you're looking forward to or you want to see in the future. Viewers, thank you for watching. Go ahead and comment or message the Jetsam Academy page with, you know, what you liked, what you didn't like, what you want to see change, let us know. And yeah, it's been great. We'll see you guys next week. Bye-bye now.
Bye.
Bye.